Hello, everyone, and welcome to a new episode, part of the Microsoft Sentinel in the Field series. In the last few weeks, we have released a lot of new features in Microsoft Sentinel. So I think for this one, we're going to publish back-to-back episodes. Is that correct, Javier?
That's right. Yeah, the pace of innovation in Sentinel doesn't stop. So we have to keep up too, right? So in this episode, we're going to have Julian Gonzalez from the Sentinel engineering team to talk to us about a series of features. So we're going to talk about basic logs, the new archive tier, and the search and restore feature. Welcome to the show, Julian.
Hi, thank you. Thank you, Javier. Thank you, Chris. Happy to be here.
Definitely. So Julian, we're talking about multiple features here. So let's try to break it down so that it's definitely easier for our viewers to be able to digest it. Can you explain what the new basic logs feature is about?
Yeah, great idea. So basic logs is a new way of ingesting data at a low cost into Microsoft Sentinel. Every environment has telemetry that has security value, but it's normally not needed for detections. So ideally, we would like to be able to keep all our data in the seam so that analysts can search over it. But at the same time, we don't need to incur the high cost of data for the high ingestion cost for this data. So with basic logs, you have the best of both worlds. You can have this data in your seam at a very low ingestion cost, which is around 75% cheaper than the normal ingestion cost.
Wow, I'll take that 75% discount. Yes. But correct me if I'm wrong. I guess that with these basic logs, we don't have the same set of capabilities that we have with the normal logs, right?
Correct. So in basic logs, you have restrictions. So first of all, basic logs can't be used in the Sentinel analytic rules. Also, the KQL language is limited. It's a great subset of features like filtering, parsing, and so on. But you can't do advanced things like joins and unions. It's really focused or scoped to whatever you can do with the WHERE clause. And the last and most important thing is that these logs are retained for 8 days before they're moved to the archive tier. And although all that is how long you keep it in archive is up to you.
Okay, so we got another second feature here, which is the archive tier. Based off the name, I'm guessing that it has to do with long-term retention?
Yes, that's it. So this new archive tier provides cheaper retention costs for long-term storage or long-term data storage compared to our previous log analytics retention costs. We're talking an 80% savings. So while keeping this data and keeping this data available for queries for analysts. So this new tier can be used for both basic logs and normal logs. And we now call what we used to have as just normal logs or the regular logs, analytic logs. So very important, the new archive tier can keep data for up to 7 years.
Well, great addition, because I remember that previously we could only keep data up to 2 years. So great to see this new enhancement. Okay, so to summarize up to now, we can now ingest data at cheaper rates with the basic logs, and we can also retain that data for longer time with a great discount as we discussed. But how do we access this data in the archive tier, in this new tier?
So data in the archive tier is accessed through a new search menu in Microsoft Sentinel. The search feature allows you to use the same set of KQL commands that you would with basic logs, and it'll execute your search jobs in the background. And it will return those results, even if your search needs to sweep through a lot of data. And the way it returns those results is through a table in the workspace called that's a search table that has all your search results in it. And once that data is in your search results table, you can do joins and any kind of queries you want on that data.
Wow. So we've talked already about the basic logs, the archive tier. What about restore?
So imagine you need to perform a full investigation or deep investigation on logs that are in the archive tier. In that case, search might be suboptimal because it only will return back the results that match your search. So we have this new restore capability that allows you to just bring back everything in that archive into analytic logs so you can perform full KQL operations on that data.
Very cool. Can we see a demo, please, Julian?
About time.
Let's go. So you first come into the Sentinel page, the first page. It's a new blade under General called Search. And I'll minimize that. So it's really just like the UI is this very simple search. In the near future, we'll have the ability to manipulate the search results, the search that you perform. But right now, it's very simple. You come in here, you pick your time range. Now, search can be a year, but it doesn't matter where that year is. So of course we keep data now for 7 years, so you can go 7 years back. In this case, just go back to last year, let's say January. And then I'll make it to December, December 31st. And then I'll apply it to, you can pick any table, you know, any table you want. I'll just do the security event table here. Like that. So that's it.
You can only do one table at a time, right, I guess, Julian?
Sure. All right. I'll just do a search. This is PC, this one machine that's been giving me problems. So that's it. It's asynchronous, so you'll get a notification when it's done. The search, what it does is it's essentially like a MapReduce job that breaks your search up into multiple jobs in parallel and runs them, executes them out all at the same time. So you can perform a search across petabytes of data, supports petabytes. The timeout is 24 hours. So you can imagine all these jobs running at the same time. So there's really no way that these jobs can fail for the most part. You can view your saved searches. So here we see that the search is already in progress. I can show you some of the searches I've done in the past. The search results get populated into a table within the workspace. So once that table is in your workspace, you can just do any kind of query on it. There's no restrictions on the queries.
Yeah, because one of the problems that we had also with other platforms is like when you were running the queries, they would time out, right? If you perform a query that is not optimal, it basically timed out and then you couldn't see the results. But with this one, no matter how the query is, you're gonna get the results always, right?
Exactly. So this is the behavior you're referring to is like an interactive behavior. So it has to have some kind of timeout that's in reasonable time. But this is an asynchronous job. You can actually leave, have it run, go do other activities. And then when those search results come in, they actually get populated to the table as the data is flowing into the system or as the results are flowing in. So it's all asynchronous. So in this example, you can see we have the results from all the table. Let's see if I can show you the top. So you can see back, I have data in this table. Even though I set it for a year, the first search results were back in October when I first saw this. So this data goes across, it works across all the tiers. So it works across archive, it also works across basic logs, it works across the analytic logs. So if you have a table that, or a data that's in more than one stage or the life cycle, it's more than one life cycle at the time of the search, it'll just work fine for that as well. Oh, just a few more things on this search. So when you click on the card here, it gives you a full status of the current of the search. It actually even shows you, you can see the search query that we ran in the background. And you can delete here. You can also restore. So I'll click on that. There's a few ways to restore. We also have restore up there.
Oh, by the way, before you go into the restore, Julian, these search operations, they have a small cost, right? Is that correct?
Currently in preview, we're not charging, but yes, in the future, we will be charging for these, and that information is already listed on the pricing page, so you can go there. Right. It only occurs, the charges are only to logs in this new low-cost tier. They're not, if you're searching across analytic logs, let's say you have terabytes or petabytes of data you want to search in analytic logs, there's no charge for that. It's only on logs such as archive or basic. We charge half a cent per gig scanned. But that currently in preview, that's not being charged. It will be charged in the future. But so restoration, when I try to do a restoration, it told me I already have one for this table. As you can see here, this is a security event table. I had already restored it. So I'll go ahead and just click on this. So what we do is we take the data that's historical or in archive. It can be an archive. Ideally, it would be archive data, but it's okay if it's not. But we're really optimized for archive data. So you take data in archive and you load it into the hot cache, meaning that it gets loaded into memory. The queries are very fast. It's the equivalent of having data just recently ingested. It's that low. So you can do all kinds of queries on these. It supports full joins, anything, any kind of time series, all those kind of more advanced query types. It supports all of those. The data is, it's think of it as a view, like a SQL view, but the data is not ingested when you do a restore. We essentially take the data that's existing in the system. It never moves. It doesn't move across regions. It's not exported. It stays within the workspace, and it gets restored into hot cache or hot memory for queries. As you can see, the queries are very fast.
Okay. So the idea for the restore is to use it when you have to manage a big amount of data, right? So for small amounts of data or to look for IOCs and things like that, we can use the search. But when you need to bring a large amount of data into hot cache, it's better to use restore.
Exactly. And I think for almost 99% of the cases, I think search is going to be fine, and it's going to work fine for those scenarios. But there are scenarios where you just want to, if you have a really intense investigation and you want to look at every single log entry or every single record event in the logs during a certain time frame, this is what you would use for that.
Perfect.
Hey, Julie, can you mention some of like the examples of targeted sources that would be viable for search and also restore?
Yeah, sure. So search, we can search across all sources. So anything, it doesn't have to be basic logs. In some cases, it might make sense to use search if you're trying to search across long time periods or across a lot of data, or that time, you know, an interactive type of search may not be appropriate because of timeouts and stuff like that. So that's what the search, but search works across all those data types. And restoration as well. Restoration works across all the data types also.
Excellent.
One more question, Julian. How do I configure the retention? So imagine that I'm a customer that is already using Sentinel, and I want to use this new data archive tier for some of my tables, right? So how do I do that? Currently, I believe that API is one of the methods, but are there other methods to do this?
Yeah, so we have a script in GitHub that you can use. And we have, there's a shortcut to that, some instructions on that, and this guided feedback. We have videos on that, so I'll show you how to enable right here. Gives you all the instructions on how to do that.
Oh, beautiful, with a video and everything. Cool, cool, cool.
And so, if there's a lot of other useful links in this guides and feedback too. We have links to the documentation, links to the underlying APIs if you want to use those, how to configure the basic logs, how to configure archive logs, of course. And another important point here is basic logs does support ingestion time transforms. So if you want to use pre-ingestion time transformation, parsing and filtering of your data, it supports that. There's a lot of advantages. One is it brings your cost down even more because you're dropping data from the ingestion that you're dropping data essentially that you don't need, so you pay less for it. You also get a chance to filter it, parse it, so it looks very clean into your table, and the queries are much easier or easier to use for the analysts as well. If you have data that has a lot of like single columns with a lot of data packed into it, you may want to pre-parse it to make it easier on the analyst. So all that is supported with basic logs, and we have some documentation in here on that as well.
Perfect. Perfect. Yeah, we'll try to cover this new feature, also the transformation at ingestion time, in some other episode, because it's also quite important for Sentinel customers. So yeah.
Yep.
Hey, Glenn, can you expand a bit about what's coming next or additional capabilities that we're adding to both search and restore?
Sure. So for search, we're planning on making it easier for you to, as you can see, when I did the search, I didn't really have a chance to make any modifications to the underlying query. So let's say I wanted to where victim PC is this, but maybe there's some noise in the system you want to filter out in cases of this, don't include that in the search results, that kind of thing. So those kind of filters will implement a feature to let you manipulate this, also bring some interactiveness to this. So when you do create that query, you get some interactive results right away before you submit the search job. So everything I submitted here is like a search job. It's an asynchronous job. So giving you the ability to manipulate that. Also, search suggestions. So the ability to suggest for the system to give you suggestions on where to search and what to search for. And another exciting project we have is NLP, or natural language processing, which where you can ask in a natural language what you're doing, and it'll give you suggestions, and you can actually run those as search jobs.
So great. Thank you so much, Julian, for showing us this great new set of features. Thanks a lot for coming to the show.
Thank you.
Thanks again, everyone, for engaging in another episode, part of the Microsoft Sentinel in the Field series. We covered another episode. In this episode, we focus on search, basic logs, the archive tier, restore, a really good balance that's really going to empower your SOC to have a balance when it comes to long-term retention. See you next time.